grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My sisters, my brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries together today. I confess,
Almighty God,
to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have grave sin in my thoughts and in my words,
in what I have done,
in what I have failed to do,
through my faults,
through my fall,
whom I was freely called.
Therefore I ask Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on all of us, forgive us our sins, and bring us into everlasting life.
Amen.
Stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord, fidelity. Moses at once bowed down to the ground in worship. Then he said, "If I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along in our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people. Yet pardon our wickedness and sins, and receive us as your own." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,
might of eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the Holy Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
That first reading is to share the Gospel of the Old Testament. The words of Moses, they remind us that God has created each one of us here today, all of us, as his own. God loves us, and we all belong to him. We belong to God. We are all God's beloved children. His love is unconditional. We know that. His love is unchanging. God's love for all of us is absolute, and we can't escape it. God loves us not because of who we are, but because of who God is. We know God is rich in mercy and kindness. How many times in our lives has God showed his tender mercy, his kindness for us? Our relationship with the Holy Spirit, it's not any kind of abstract proposition. The Holy Spirit, we know, third person of the Trinity, can impact our lives, and he does every day in very life-changing ways. The Holy Spirit breathes life into dry bones and stagnant relationships. The Holy Spirit pours out God's love into our hearts each day. That Holy Spirit transforms fear into freedom. Isolation becomes community. And the Holy Spirit sends people out with purpose. Jesus said, receive the Spirit, who is the apostle, who sins you forgive, the forgiven, who sins you retain, the retained. Go out and preach. Jesus gave those men and women the power to do that. And so they left that upper room and Pentecost Sunday and did what the Lord commanded them to do. And God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. If we forget God's love for us, all we have to do is look to the cross to be reminded of that. His fidelity, it keeps God on our side, offering us through Jesus his love, his forgiveness, his healing, his salvation. No matter how messy things may get in our lives, Jesus invites all of us, each one of us, into a very intimate relationship. And Jesus offers us his truth, his life, and his goals. In whatever stage of life, or system, my brother, we might find ourselves, we can respond to God's invitation in three very simple, very concrete ways: prayer, learning, and life in our church. Prayer, more than we can imagine, God wants to be known by all of us, welcomed into our lives. Maybe we're struggling with believing and experiencing that we're a beloved child of God and loved unconditionally. Plainly, and with perseverance, let's ask that God the Father reveals his love to us, and he does, and he will. Sometimes we feel aimless, not sure the way. Explicitly, we surrender our lives to Christ. We confess that he's our Lord. We commit to following him. Jesus will show us the way. The scriptures will be our guide. We sometimes feel scared of life. We pray. We plead for the fullness of fortune, the Holy Spirit, to be poured out into our lives. So boldly, don't be afraid. Ask the Spirit, the giver of all life. Learning. To be in relationship means to continue to learn more about the other. And faith formation helps us to learn more about our God and grow in our spiritual lives. Life in our church. Grow in relationship. God needs to grow in relationship with the body of Christ. So we are the body of Christ and involved in our church and our community here at St. Albert. The God who fashioned us out of love, has prepared a banquet for his beloved. We give him thanks for not to have our glory, as we prepare to receive him.
Amen.
Let's now together, my brothers and sisters, profess our faith and our loving and caring Father. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all things, God from God's light to light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. For him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, who was incarnate, the Virgin Mary, became man. For our Savior was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and of his kingdom there will be no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. Let's join our brother Drew now as he leads us in our prayer of the faithful today. Gathered in Christ's name and empowered by the Holy Spirit, we now humbly present our prayer and our petitions to our loving Father.
For the church, that it may always be the healing and hope-filled presence of Jesus Christ in the world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace to live in peace and harmony, that God will help us accept the differences of one another, understand the gifts that others bring, and give us patience as we strive to work together, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those searching for God, that the Spirit may inspire them to find God in all the good works of those around them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those suffering from the pain of sickness and injury, especially those listed in our parish bulletin, may they find peace and wholeness through the gentle touch of God's Spirit, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, our family members, our friends, our fellow parishioners, and especially Katajina and Yoga Yusef Dempsey, Cheslas Gabbeck, Walt and Walter Wage. May they all enjoy everlasting happiness and peace in God's heavenly kingdom, we pray. For ourselves and for all those baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, that each of us may proclaim the good news by the way we live our lives, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Andrew Petruszewski, who celebrates the anniversary of his birth, that God may continue to bless him with peace, happiness, and good health, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the many personal prayers deep within our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father God, you are present to your people by your mighty deeds and well within all of us through your grace. As we celebrate this day in your name, listen to our prayers. Give us a taste of the wonderful harmony of the Holy Trinity by bringing peace into our world, our homes, and our hearts. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit.
Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just our duty and salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in the Trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in the confessing of the true and the eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, the unity of the substance, and the equality in majesty. For this is praised by the angels and the archangels, cherubim, too, and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day as in one voice together today.
The mystery of
Mary, Mother of God, the Apostle Peter, the Paul, I need you. My peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, Lord, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord be with all of you. May receive the sacrament, O Lord,